From the ashes of the old world, in the shadows of the last great war, the world was shattered by magic. Plains became deserts, mountains crumbled into the sea. Witches and heretics are burned in the street, lined with oathbreakers hung by their necks. Where once was law, order, empire, now only hardship and savagery remain. To the east, in Highport, a weary king rules an ungrateful people. To the west, his brother keeps swords sheathed and words of rebellion at bay. To the north and south, savage elves and cowardly dwarves openly practice arcane arts, shrouded by leaf and stone. In a time when a man's worth is measured by his word, when might makes right, and a quick death is a mercy, only those more foolish than brave venture far from home. The age of peace and prosperity has ended. In its place, only strife.
Hey, everybody, and welcome to Age of Strife. How has the last 2 weeks treated you guys?
Pretty well, for me.
Really well.
What's been going on?
I started playing in a new D&D campaign in 5th edition. And I have a pretty good story from last session. Actually, I'm playing a halfling sorcerer. I'm using the wild magic sorcerer's origin. And we were fighting a group of hags last session, and they had these necklaces that were eyeballs, and there were two of them. And if you had one on, you could see through the other eye. And I ended up uniting them, and I got possessed by a hag, which started casting spells at my party. But the first spell it casted, it had to roll on the wild magic table. And I turned into a potted plant, and the necklaces fell off. So I was saved by my wild magic. It was incredible.
Turned into a potted plant. What an epic escape from certain death.
Yeah.
Were you ever able to be turned back into a halfling?
Yeah, it's you turn into a potted plant until the end of your turn, I think.
Okay. So. Cool.
Yeah. I turned into a pot of mushrooms and then popped back into a halfling real quick.
Fifth Ed is not as strong as Second Ed. How are you finding Fifth Ed?
It's a lot different, but I really like I really like the wild magic for one. It's a new experience playing a caster, I guess. So it's a lot of fun.
Wild magic is pretty fun.
Yeah,
it can be a little dicey sometimes, but
yeah, I was. A little when we were fighting those hags, and I also popped into the astral plane for a bit
just to hang out and check out your silver cord.
Yeah, just hanging around.
Nice. What about the rest of you? It looks like you got a new haircut, Jeff.
I did. It was the highlight of my week. Also, I got a new puppy.
Oh, where's
the
puppy?
Did you want to see him?
Yes, we do.
Yes,
hang on. I've got a wait. Angus.
Angus.
Yeah. Angus.
Good boy. Yeah, named him Angus. Actually, no one named him Angus. Say him. I can't see. Can you see him?
Yeah. Oh my god, he's adorable.
He is. Good boy. Now I'm gonna put you in bed. He's not gonna be happy in a second. Apart from that, my 2 weeks have been good. Haircut and dog.
What about you guys? Tyler, what's been up?
Ooh, 2 weeks. Let's see here. I played a visual novel for the first time.
Ooh, which one?
Let's see. It was called Lucy, the Eternity She Wished For.
How was it?
It was pretty good. I don't think visual novels are my favorite genre, but... And there are a lot of things that were a little weird because of translation, I'm guessing, mostly. But it inspired me a little bit. I thought, I could probably make these kind of games. So,
Are we going to be seeing a Tyler-themed or a Tyler-written visual novel in the future?
Maybe. I'd have to go find an artist because I do a lot of things, but art is not one of them, not really.
Here ya.
Yeah. I could do like technical drawings of a visual novel about writing blueprints or something. Don't think that would go over too well. Other than that, I've been horribly irresponsible with my money, which is always fun.
Nice.
I found this game called Chronicles of Illyria, which isn't out yet, and threw way too much money at it and regretted my decision the next day. But, you know.
You're just going to have to play the crap out of it now.
Yeah. Yeah, hopefully it's good and isn't terrible. And
I've seen that Chronicles of Illyria as well. When I first saw it, I was like, it's got like lots of good ideas and the things that I want to play. Obviously, I'm too poor to invest in it, but I keep on checking up on it, and I think I'll play it and maybe buy it if it finishes.
Yeah. That was my big concern about it. Hopefully they can actually pull off most of the things they're planning to. And I looked into their technology and some of that stuff, and it seems promising. Like it could be pulled off. We'll see if they can do it.
I thought the same thing about EverQuest Next, and that just shattered my dream. It was a Abandonware, vaporware from the start. Actually, speaking of that, I actually spent another $150 on Pantheon. So,
Pantheon?
Yeah, it's been brought out by Brad McQuaid, who did EQ and Vanguard.
Mm-hmm.
So he's putting up a new one to try and get community back into MMOs. So it's pretty much just an EverQuest 2, if EverQuest 2 had never been made.
Well, what about you, Autumn? How's the last couple of weeks treated you?
I've been sort of binge watching Ancient Aliens almost every day. And it's been giving me like stupid ideas for DMing. So I'm thinking of just like working on a whole new setting based on Ancient Aliens and for this fancy D&D game, because it doesn't fit with my current setting. I can make some things work because good ideas. But apart from that, I did run a game set in a Japanese setting where you've got two samurai factions fighting, and the players are not part of it, and they move in to solve the conflict. I'm not spoiling anything, but I ripped off a PS2 game for that. It's called Way of the Samurai.
Cool. So let's talk about what happened last gameplay week, a couple weeks ago. Where are we? What's been going on? Why is this peaceful music misleading?
well, actually, death is imminent.
But. Well, that's the thing. Like, give it half an hour, that might actually be really fitting.
So. At the start of last session, was it the Freshers, their soldiers, they went out to hunt down the werewolf?
Yeah.
They tracked it pretty well as we did, and it led into the forest. And we met them at the 3-mile border, where we turned back, but they sort of stayed there and didn't come back. You know, 3 days later or however many days later, they didn't come back. So we had some sort of chat. We did some business with the caravan as well before they left. And then we set out to Nixon. Did we do anything in between?
No, I think it was just the caravan stuff.
Yeah, nothing really interesting. Actually, Neil, just can I get confirmation that it is actually the Wyatts that have found the gold? I was really watching it, and initially you said the Genhals made the announcement in front of the
council. In the Tuk Tuk Mountains?
Yeah. But then everything else after that was the Wyatts, so.
Let me sort through my notes here. Why don't we keep recapping? I'll sort through the notes and we'll check in.
Mm-hmm. So we decided to approach Nixon by the southern eastern side, which was the more dangerous side. And we camped outside and then made our way in the morning, was it?
Yeah.
And we headed straight to the large church with the tower. And as soon as we got in there, we went up the stairs to the tower. And on the next floor, we found a weird elephant guy. He had dark gray skin, big elephant trunk, claws, and monstrous features. And we just killed it very quickly because we are ruthless monsters. And so we went to the top of the tower and spotted out the building that our father had told us that was the significant landmark where he had buried the treasure. So we figured out our way to get there and we descended the stairs. But before we left, we thought we'd take a look in the basement of this church. Also, while we were in Nixon, we noticed that pretty much every building had no doors whatsoever.
Yes, there's a surprising lack of doors in Nixon.
Yeah, and burn marks where there should have been doors.
I think it was Cat Thresher that was talking to you, Stefan? Right? It was a...
It was the Ginhalls who made the initial announcement, but then afterwards it was the Wyatts that approached us. Yeah.
Okay, because my notes don't specify. I could have sworn it was Cat Thresher. It couldn't have been the Wyatts. They are head of family. You know, with Condi Wyatt recently dying. It had to have been the Genhalls then. I could have sworn it was the Threshers. Okay. Did I not give a name of the person that was talking to you? Was it Quinn?
I think it was like the husband of the late Lady Wyatt or something. Or that's
It was the Wyatts at the time. That could have been an oops moment, but...
Okay. So it was the husband of the late Lady Wyatt. If I gave two different names, then and my notes don't tell me which one it was supposed to be, I'm not remembering. I think we're gonna go with Wyatt because it was supposed to be one of the higher up families, and Wyatts are the third in line after the Countess's family and the Threshers. The Genhalls don't have the resources to have figured out anything in the mountains.
Okay, cool. Right. Thank you for that.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So you guys are where in Nixon right now?
We descended down the stairs, and we heard the sound of the preachers chanting some sort of almost religious-like chants, and we went down, set up an ambush, killed one of them quickly, the others retreated, we looted the place, chased them up the stairs. We saw them fleeing from us, and then we headed down towards the river where we encountered the Sifu man who threw bricks at us.
He got eight attacks around.
And Stefan did massive damage throughout this adventure, beat the Sifu man. And then we killed those carp that came out with their four human legs, was it?
Two legs, but yeah.
Two, okay. And then slithering out of the buildings came the tentacle squid beak octopus things. We killed one of them, another one escaped, and then we ended just about there. Oh, and somewhere in between, we saw the black and white temple creatures that we shot some arrows at, and they fled. Is that everything?
I think so. Yeah. We ended, right by a blue roofed house, which is, we saw that from the top of the tower and thought, okay, we can cut into town from there and get to the estate that we're looking for.
Actually, I remember it differently. I remember that we'd already got the loot and then we were just outside next.
You might actually be right about that. I must have just blacked out for that part.
Okay. Probably
that's why we got this music.
No. So you guys are near to this, I guess you're right adjacent to this blue roofed house. Do we remember where, how badly surrounded you guys are? I think you just ran off the people who are near you. There's no one within sight, but there were people down the causeway, down the waterway.
Yeah, there was the weird cult back down the river that we shot arrows at, and they scattered.
And they scattered, and then we ducked in from there. So theoretically, they might not know where we've gone exactly.
Right.
We put the tentacle guys pretty quickly, the big men.
And let's do a check in with how much HP you all have.
I'm one hit from death.
Nice.
Four.
I'm at eight out of 13. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
six HP.
And Ginger?
I am at 21 out of 21.
I didn't even realize this when we were playing last session. And then she said so after, and I was like, wait a minute, you have 21 HP?
Most HP in the party hasn't taken a wound.
Yeah. So we're at the DM Hacks Bears.
21 HP isn't amazing. I'm a level 3 fighter with a +1 on the con, you know?
Hang on. Amazing, you know? Just to give you a comparison, I have 11 max hit points as a level 3 fighter. I'm like a glass cannon without the cannon. If my next level isn't a high roll, I'm
well, my character's older, so it kind of makes sense.
I also have the lowest AC in the party.
She does have more con. She does get a +1 to HP on each roll.
Yeah, that's great. That's an extra 3 hit points.
Okay. So you guys are in Nixon. You are adjacent to this blue-roofed house. The river is just behind you. And down the street is this noble estate that you are told there's a great amount of wealth in, buried near the cellar door underneath a rock.
Yeah.
If I recall correctly.
I don't know if stealth will help us. We need to get in there now.
It's supposed to be behind the house, I think, so let's get back there.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'll be pointing for Ginger to lead the way, because she looks much more healthy than the rest of us.
Of course. I'm gonna lead up front, shield up ready, and we're circling around this building, yeah.
Okay. Do you have both your donkeys with you, or just the one?
Both of them.
Okay, both donkeys.
Well, someone in the party is sharing the rope to lead them.
Sure.
I thought it was just one that we took.
We definitely have two, because I remember last session drawing the map, we drove two in the little crypt area.
Yeah, because I remember theorizing, if someone goes down, we can tie the donkeys together with rope and then lay the person on top of the two donkeys.
You don't have to carry make them. Sure the donkeys don't.
Let's see. Here is our little battle map that we had for the underground area. I see SGAL and 2Ds, so there must be two donkeys.
I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Unless you include the head as one donkey and the ass as another donkey.
Not this time. Maybe in the future you can get a two-headed donkey.
Oh, hell yeah. And we've got walking fear.
Donkey.
I'm calling them child stitch, by the way.
Okay, so you guys push down the cobblestone streets towards this mansion that you can see. It's maybe 1,000 feet down the fairly straight shot of a street. Can I get perception checks from the party?
Yeah. Nice.
Ooh, 31, 28,
18,
and
24.
Okay.
Well, that's my first file.
Oh, and the overlays are working. We've got to work out some technical issues later. You guys go ahead and... Are you three out of the four of you... can spot as you're going down this through the little alleyways on the other side the shifting shapes of monsters watching you. You might catch like an eye stalk peering around at one area and then it kind of receding, or maybe a set of claws and a weird misshapen humanoid face poking around as you go down between these alleyways. But it becomes clear that on either side of you are other monsters on streets over from you.
All right, we need to go fast, everyone.
Okay.
If they're letting us through, we're gonna have issues coming out the other end.
Maybe they'll just let us through. Maybe they like us.
Somehow I doubt that.
Well, if they all know each other, then maybe. No, we just killed them all. Look. No. When we are moving, we have view of, we were from the river, so we're going towards the mansion. There's the bridge, right? We had a view of the bridge at some point.
Yeah, on the river you have a view of the one remaining standing bridge.
Okay, because it's bridge or back where we came from as our escape route, so just thinking it through. Okay.
You proceed down the streets until you come to the wall that surrounds the estate with the columns on it that you know to be the one you are looking for. There's a small wall, maybe 6.5 feet tall, that goes around the perimeter. It looks pretty overgrown. There were some bushes on the other side that have grown up out and kind of over the top. Trees are overgrown. You can see sections where roots are buckling the wall and coming out on the other side. Wall's mostly intact, and it wouldn't be a problem to climb considering the amount of vegetation that is growing up on both sides of it. Except for the donkey.
Yeah, that's annoying.
Let's keep going around. There must be an entrance in, and I'm guessing if they don't like doors, there's probably no gate either.
Yeah, you have a point.
Okay. You guys circle the building. Going around the long way, unfortunately, until you come to the gate. Sure enough, the gate is knocked off its hinges, but this one's just lying on the ground in front. It's not been taken away or burned out or something.
It hasn't been eaten like the rest of the doors.
Or eaten, or used at some sort of strange ceremony. Or whatever
What's
popular theories are
gate
out there.
Made out of?
It's an iron gate, a wrought iron gate that's just been kind of knocked down and pushed to the side a little bit.
Okay.
And before you, there's a 30-foot open area with little gardens that are wildly overgrown in a moldy pond. And then these large columns that support the roof over a porch. What's the word? Porch.
What's the roof like?
Tiles. Red tiles.
Is it slanted?
The section just over the porch is fairly flat, but then the roof behind that is steeped.
Okay, does it look like it goes all the way to the back of the house?
The roof?
Yeah. Like the flat part?
No.
No.
Hmm.
The flat part's just over the front door.
Right, just over the porch, which is maybe 8 feet deep.
I'm trying to decide the feasibility of using my grappling hook and getting onto the roof.
It doesn't look like there's a lot of things that would hold the weight of a grappling hook. There are tiles, but tiles are likely to just slide off if you grappling hook onto them, if you can somehow manage because of the way that they're stacked.
Okay.
Well, guys, we know the treasure's next to the cellar door, which I'm guessing is behind. Yeah, it's on the back side. There's a big rock over the spot on the southern side.
Shall we start digging or Would we? Do we have time?
That's why we brought the spades.
All right.
It can't be too deep. I don't think Father would have all the time in the world to bury it so deep.
Okay.
Okay. You guys move in, go around the perimeter of the house on the inside of the wall, and sure enough, on the backside, there is a cellar door, and there's a rock kind of awkwardly sitting against it, against the side of it.
That's one quick move. I'll get the shovels out.
Okay. You guys grab the shovels, move the rock aside, and start digging. Very quickly, your spades start hitting metal. It takes a little while, but you can uncover this sack of wonderful things. You open it up, and it is exactly what your father had said. It is filled with gold and silver trinkets looted from the houses of nobles.
All right, so the donkey's helped us get out.
Yeah.
Should we cut away from the bridge, like perpendicular, and then turn from there?
Yeah, I think
same way.
We had like a 30-something with a natural 20 on our perception check from the tower, so I'm hoping we know the best way from here.
Mm-hmm.
It was a few ways, right?
Yeah, so you can go over the bridge, or you can head further east and try and find one of the holes in the wall and go through that, or you can head through the southern section of the wall near the river that you know you can go through, or you can swim across the river.
Nah. I don't know about that. I think the bridge is probably the fastest, right?
Definitely the fastest.
Okay. It'd also be very visible on that bridge.
That's true.
I don't think there's a lot of creatures on the other side of the bridge. Once we got there, it might be easier, but maybe we'd be best off just going east and looking for the hole in the wall, since that's the opposite way we've come from.
Yeah, we came from the west, and there are all those monsters over there. Which way is the keep from here? Is it to the east?
The keep is east and a little bit south.
So I think we go east northeast.
Are you sure you want to go to the? Oh, I guess if we stay a little bit north, we won't go towards the keep. Yeah, let's go east.
Or just cut north, and then east.
So you want to go east through the wall of the town? Through the broken down section of wall.
Yeah. So we circled the town, Neil. Did we see the broken down sections like enough to say it's pretty likely we could find it?
I don't think you would have trouble finding it. You know, you might come out a little bit south of it if you're going through the city streets that you've never been through, but you could find your way to that. You just have to cross most of the town to get there. The keep is in the center, and you're not quite yet at the keep, so the eastern wall is, 75% of the way through the town.
The bridge is slightly north of us, isn't it?
Slightly north of you.
Perhaps another thing, we haven't actually been to the bridge. We can just go north and cut through the bridge.
Yeah, I think first we should go north, get to where we think we're level with the bridge, and then cut west.
Yeah, let's do that.
You guys hear this clacking sound, like rock on rock.
Can I tell which way it's coming from?
Sounds like it's coming from the front side of the house.
Okay, I'm gonna say... Oh, shit. Donkeys. Can Luther Kool-Aid Man through the wall?
Hold on. If we've got this estate, has it got two ways to get to the back?
You can go around the house on either side to get to the front or the back. Right?
Okay. Yeah. All right. I was just thinking, like, maybe we could make a sound on that side and then run around the other side, like, shoot a crossbow bolt over there. And then run around. Look at Stefan.
How big's the rock that was sitting over the treasure?
Not super big. Maybe like this size. Enough that it's heavy.
The wall on one side of the house.
Enough that you could throw it?
Yeah.
It would be more of like a bashing thing. It probably weighs 15 or 20 pounds. You wouldn't be able to throw it very far.
I guess... Acting doesn't include ventriloquism.
No. That's a separate skill.
Okay, well, I'll tell Ginger that I like the idea. and wait for someone to do something.
I'm gonna start leading the donkeys around one side and suggest one of the ranged weapon people to shoot an arrow to the other side to hit the wall to make a sound on that side.
Just with the trinkets and that, did they weigh a great deal, or could we get it all into one donkey if it was all in one sack?
Probably weighs... I didn't come up with a weight for it. It probably weighs like 30 or 40 pounds.
So that should be fine for the donkey then. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. After the squire, make a distraction.
All right, you wanted to fire an arrow at something?
I point to the other side of the, as we're at the back of the building, other side of the wall. I just say, hit that wall as we go the other way around the building.
So you guys are, the front door is to the north. The cellar is in the back, so it's on the south side of the estate. So you want him to shoot at like the east wall while you guys go around west, or for him to shoot at the west wall while you go around east?
Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Cool.
All right.
Tyler?
Okay. Yeah, as they start going that way, I'll pull let's see here. What kind of arrows do I have? I'll pull a broadhead out and point it at the opposite wall.
Okay.
Take a shot here. I don't know.
Don't go too high.
One made out of
wall. One made out of wall. Fine. Yeah, it's a wall. It's not hard to miss, or it's not hard to hit. Your arrow pings on the wall as the rest of the party goes around the other side. As you guys cut around the corner and come to the front corner of the building, you see that that front doorway that you walk through, the gateway, there are rocks, like little bricks being stacked on top of it. And you see some kind of levitating, floating bricks just slowly moving into position and then setting themselves down. The wall's not, the building section of the wall is not very high. It's maybe, you know, five bricks deep or five bricks tall. And covering the width of the small area. You could easily step over it, but there's a slow stacking of bricks from the ruined rubble that just kind of comes floating in and setting down.
Guys, we're just gonna have to break out of this. Break out and then just run right, run north.
Keep an eye out for another clear man, though.
All right.
I'll lead. If there's this stack of bricks in front of the gate, I would say we just lead through and defend ourselves on if it looks like it's going to get dangerous.
The bricks continue to slowly stack.
We're not stopping to allow it to stack. All
right, you're going through. Okay.
Yeah.
Who's in the front?
I'm in the front.
All right, Ginger. You push forward, run through towards where these bricks are slowly being stacked up. The bricks that are floating and kind of hovering in the air towards this wall stop as you run through. Stepping on the other side of the gate, you notice to your left, to the west, to where the bridge is, are a pack of two-headed dogs. There are four of them, and they growl as we roll for initiative.
And there's Brooklyn. Hey, I know what we do. We capture this translucent thing. We take it back to Wadsworth and let it rebuild the wall.
If only.
Oh, dear.
All right, spear attack. And the rest of the party are all keeping up, right?
No, we've gone the other way. We're climbing up the wall.
I'm guessing Arthur would be...
I have my bow out, so...
Terrible rolls. Jeff and Patrick, you go first. I'm sorry. Stefan and Luther, you go first.
All right, dogs. Damn, that makes running hard. I'm going to try and turn and just run. So can we go north? What's the
bridge
direction?
Is like a little bit north, maybe a half block north, and then due east. Who has the donkeys, by the way? Who's leading them?
So I would usually lead the donkeys, but in this case, Luffy's put me as the leading person, so I would hope that someone else is leading them.
I'll take the donkeys.
No, I think Luffy's taken over, because he can throw daggers and lead the donkeys.
So Stefan and Luffy.
Stefan, you're just running.
Yeah. At least around the corner.
Okay, well, Luther's just throwing daggers at the dogs.
Okay, you're going to have to get out into the street because you can't see them through the little gate. Someone make an attack roll, Jeff. You're running past the dogs? Or you're...
Oh, right. Okay, yep. So, to get there, do we have to run past the dogs? Are they
yes,
the barrier?
The dogs are on the east side, west side of you. They are between you and the bridge. I mean, you could go the other way and try and go deeper into the city and find a route to the next street over and go down that way. But the most direct path is blocked by dogs.
All right. In that case, I shall go charging at the dogs.
Excellent. Okay. Give me an attack roll.
Nice.
How's that for you, Neil?
That is beautiful. That is not a critical hit, but it is a hit against one of the two-headed dogs. These guys are big. They are well muscled. They are muscle bound. 8 damage rips through one of them, badly wounding it, but not all killing right, the it. The 16 one? Is a hit as well.
Oh, okay, on the same one then.
Yeah.
D6 plus 2.
barely enough. One short sword goes in.
No, there's an error with my. I can't type.
Oh, that should have been 8 damage.
Oh, yeah, that should have been 8 damage. Okay.
So you just barely bring down this first of the pack of 3 two-headed dogs. One short sword in the side, one into the throat, and it crumples. One of the throats crumples down with a whimper.
Oh, my initiative should be 13.
Okay, Luther.
Ooh.
Ooh. So you lead the donkeys through the wall and start tossing daggers. The first one is a critical hit against a two-headed dog.
Look, if we keep adding dog hits in this one. Oh, yeah.
What are these rolls?
Damage rolls on point.
Hey. 6 damage to the dog. It yelps with pain as you hit one of its eyes out with a dagger. And then the dogs all go. Well, the only 2 remaining go. The first one bounds towards Stefan. That's 2 heads and takes 2 bites at him. That is a 14 and a 13.
Oh, I live.
Ooh, okay. The second one... I think Ginger is probably more forward than Luther, so the second one bounds after Ginger. With a 24 and a 22.
Wow.
My AC is 18.
Okay, so the 24 is a crit and the 22 is just a hit.
Okay, I'll roll a save.
Please do.
I've forgotten my numbers. That's a fail.
That's definitely a fail. You take 8 and 3. You take 11 points of damage as the dogs rip into you.
Damn.
Let's roll a d10 for location. Location 3. Severity is 2d4. These are big, muscle-bound, nasty dogs. Severity 4. I don't think that's anything that we need to worry ourselves about. But it's your turn, I think. Tyler goes last.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So,
let me double check. One dog. Leg. Oh, leg grazed victim knocked down, actually. So you are knocked to the ground by this dog as it rips into you. And it's kind of lurking over you.
All right. So if I'm on the ground and I want to make a spear attack against the thing which is on top of me, do I have penalties?
Yes, you have a penalty while attacking from prone. You can get up, but it'll take I think it's a half move to stand up, according to the combat and tactics. So you could stand and fight.
Oh.
Or you
it's
could...
It's not stopping me from standing, is it? It's not on me?
No, but you wouldn't be able to stand and run. Or you wouldn't be able to stand, fight, and run.
I'm going to stand and attack, then.
Yeah.
Where was I? My modifiers are 3. Cool.
No. Your stab with a spear is completely useless against the dog.
And there are 2 dogs standing, right?
Yes. One of them squaring off with you, one of them squaring off with Stefan.
We only see dogs, right?
You only see dogs right now.
Okay.
But the dogs definitely weren't levitating the rocks.
Standing up from prone is treated as a full move action, so the character can do nothing else in that round except for rise. That's bullshit. You can do it as a half move. Standing up does not take a minute. I don't care how old you are. It's a half move, not a full move action.
I can't get up.
All right.
Arthur, you see your... I don't know what to call them. They're not your family members. Yet you see your employers run to this other side of the wall, and then you see Ginger get knocked down, and this big two-headed dog stalk over her as she battles her way back up. Just behind her is Luther, who's pulling daggers out while he holds the donkeys, who are kind of freaking out a little bit over this incident. You have a shot at the one that's next to Ginger, but you'd be firing into melee, so you'd have to take a penalty to hit the dog only.
Now, she is prone. Does that make it easier to hit the dog?
She stood.
I'm no longer prone.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'll take a shot at the dog then.
Okay. Penalty of 4 to make a called shot against the dog only, or 50-50 chance of hitting dog or Ginger?
I'll do it.
Your choice.
All right,
I recommend
shot
the latter.
All right, well, let's see.
Nope. No. Goes wide, landing on hitting the building behind them. Luther, second and third dagger throws.
Okay.
Ooh, miss. And that one's a hit. I take it against the same dog.
Yeah. Ooh, another max.
Wow, there's damage again.
Dude, you guys are killing it with the damage today.
I get the feeling we might need it.
Yes. Your dagger sticks in the side of the dog, which whimpers a little bit, but seems not too badly affected by it. So let's roll initiative. The pair of dogs and you guys.
Oh.
Oh, there we go.
I'm glad you're going fast.
It makes up for the rolls last round where we all had 7 or above.
There we go.
Still not great. Well, I doubt they beat a 3.
No, they have a 4, though. So, goes first?
Hold on, don't we get second shots from last round?
Oh, yes, you get... Sorry, I forgot your second shot. I gave Luther his, but I completely forgot about yours.
Yeah, there we go. Well, let's see if that... Oh,
that's a hit.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. You skewer one of the dogs in the side.
Okay.
Kill him.
How much damage does this...
So this is the same dog that Luther was attacking with the daggers. Why don't... Luther should have probably had to make penalties on his attack rolls to hit the ones, because they were all in melee also. At least your second and third shots were.
Yeah. 6 damage.
6 damage against the dog, wounding it badly. Luther, would you still have made that last attack with a -4 penalty for a called shot so you don't hit Ginger, who the dog was engaged with?
I still would have attacked. I would have had a 9 and a 13.
Yeah, 13 is one shy of a hit, though. I forgot the firing into melee adjustments.
Minus 3 damage, then.
Yeah. Restore it by 3 HP. The dog is still not looking too hot here. Arthur's second shot hit it, and Luther starts off this round.
If I'm firing into melee, I would have went for a regular dagger attack, I guess.
Sure.
I guess I'm running into melee with it.
So you just let go of the donkeys and hop into melee?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and make an attack.
Kualtha's right next to you anyway.
Ooh, critical. Ooh. Just single critical, yeah. You ram the dagger into the dog's neck, and one of the left neck at this point just kind of droops, and the left head just dangles uselessly. The right head is still up, but it is not doing so well. You can see the dog physically shaking from the loss of blood. The dog goes at 4. There's no way this dog is... Oh my god. Alright, never mind. This dog has the morale of a champion. This is the world's greatest guard dog. Even at 1 HP, it still is going to attack Ginger with a 14 to hit.
No, okay. I block.
You are not attacked. Does anyone have a 6 or better?
No.
Okay. Coming from the other side of the street, you can hear the scrapings of claws on stone. And looking back, you see what looks to be 3 people, fairly humanoid, wrapped in dirty, tattered clothes, but with furry arms, like a bear's arm almost, but, you know, thinner. But that's sort of like thick, heavy black fur extending, ending in large claws. You notice they're not wearing any shoes, and they're like the bottom half of their shin to their foot have these big furry sections with large claws on them. 3 of them appear on the other side of the street and move to close with you guys. Only 2 of them go first, though. They're going to come. One of them comes for one of the donkeys and is just going to try and pick it up. I don't think it's strong enough to pick up a donkey. So one of them struggles to, you know, wrestle the donkey in its direction, but the donkey is stubborn and will not go. The other one is going to come in for Arthur's hidden inside the building area, so it's going to come after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come after Ginger. Guy comes up with a claw and slashes at you for a 12 to hit.
Armor.
12, 13, 14 with back attack, but that's still a miss.
Which of our donkeys did we put the loose on? Just in case one of the donkeys dies, we need to clarify that.
Say yours.
Okay.
I will roll 50-50 to see which one the guy went after. Actually, why don't you roll it? 1, 2, or 3 on a d6, he picks up your donkey, Ginger. 4, 5, 6, he picks up the other donkey, or tried to.
I mean, he's not...
He's not gonna get it.
Does he look strong enough to do that?
No! You don't think he can pick up a donkey. He's got big furry arms and big furry legs, but the rest of him looks fairly humanoid, like normal human size.
Right.
You really doubt he could pick a donkey up.
Does the donkey try to kick him?
Probably. Let's see. How's the donkey feel about all of this? None too happy. The donkey goes for a kick. Good call. But a natural 1 and a natural 2 are complete misses by... What is this, Doris? Is this...
It's Spike.
Spike, thank you. I can never keep your animal's name straight.
It's the one that has lots of spears on him.
Okay. Who's next? Does anyone beat an 8?
No.
Nope, okay. The other dog goes, and it takes 2 bites at Stefan. With a 7 and a 17.
17 hits.
17 hits you for 2 points of damage.
Oh. I'm on 2 hit points.
Okay. Does anyone have a 10? or lower? Nope.
No, I think we're 11, 14.
Okay, the other man with the bare arms and claws comes down the alleyway, comes down the road, going after 50-50 between Autumn and Stefan. Autumn comes after you and takes a slash for a 7, 8, 9 with back attack is a miss. That should have been between Autumn and Ginger. I'm sorry, Ginger and Luther, but it doesn't matter. Whoever's got the 11s.
Alright.
Stefan, are you on 11 as well?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you
alright, so I'm going on the doggy with me. That's a miss. Second is also a miss.
Okay.
Okay. Ooh, so there's a dog that critical me last time, and then there's these other creatures around me. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna attack the dog.
Ooh. Stab and miss at the dog.
Yeah.
Arthur? Save the party.
Alright, well, I sling my longbow over my shoulder and draw my saber and dagger and run at the dog that was next to Ginger.
Okay. Three people piling on the dog next to Ginger.
With one HP.
Some might call it a dog pile. I choose not to.
Okay. I just have a +0 with Saber, yes. So, roll the thing.
Ooh, that's a hit! Yeah. Roll some damage. Bring the poor pup down.
Would he have flank as well?
Yes, he would have flanking.
Okay.
Damage doesn't really matter, it has 1 HP, but let's just see.
There you go.
Yeah.
Wrecks it. There's now one two-headed dog on the west side of the gate opening, and three of these bear-clawed men on the right side of the opening, the east side of the opening.
Before I take my second attack, which I'm turning for one of the bear people, I'm going to shout, are we fighting this? Waiting for a response, anyone? Okay.
No, we don't have to. I'm going to go handle it.
Yeah, the bear man. The end of the round. The end of the round.
Hold on, Arthur, you're attacking with a saber and a dagger, right?
Dagger. Yep.
So you get both attacks at the same time, so you can stab the other dog right now. Okay. Dual wielding all happens simultaneously.
Is someone flanking that one from my perspective?
You could be. It's just a dog, it's pretty easy to get to its side.
Okay, so
it's,
I'll get myself.
You know, focused on Stefan, so you can get around it, but Stefan probably couldn't.
Okay, well, there's a dagger.
Oh!
Nice.
Is that including flanking bonus?
Yes.
Okay, that is a single critical on the dog.
Okay. Alright, so that would be 2d4 plus 1.
And it fails its saving throw versus death. It takes 4 points of damage. Why don't you roll me a d10 for location and a d6 for severity, since your dagger is smaller in size than the dog.
Location 9, severity 3, so probably nothing.
Yeah, 3 is never anything. Almost never anything. Location 9, severity 3, no unusual effects, but you struck him in the torso. Ginger, you were asking if you're fighting these things?
Yeah, just a loud exclamation question. Are we fighting these?
Not if we don't have to, as I swing at the dog.
Roll the hit. Oh, ooh, double yes. Critical on the dog. Triple damage.
Yeah.
Whew.
Oh, nice. My. You rip the dog badly. It is just whimpering.
I would say I feel sorry for it, but...
Nah.
I lost all of my initiative dice. I accidentally cleared them. Oh, shit. the dogs already both went, right? Or
yeah.
One went.
Yeah. Yeah,
two
no,
dogs
no, both went.
Like three bear people went.
Yeah.
Everyone went this round already.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay,
we're making
cool.
Our second attacks.
Right. Yeah. Perfect. Party finished up your turn. That's why I cleared the dice, is because they were done with their attacks.
guess I'll do my second attack against the bear thing that is fighting me. Oh no, might as well just not have rolled.
Saving throw versus death?
Oh no.
It's failed by a lot.
Failed by a lot.
Number again. 13's my number.
I think that is... Did you fail by 8 then? Yeah. I think that is fire... make an attack... What is it?
Retarget nearby things.
Yeah. So adjacent to you are two of these bear-clawed folks and Luther. And Arthur is... they're all around you in
Arthur
general.
Arthur went to the other dog.
Mm-hmm. Arthur did go to the other dog. That's probably far enough away. So why don't you roll me a D3 on a 1 you target Luther. A D2. On 1 you target Luther, on 2 you target the other bear man.
Can I roll to hit, then roll the D2?
No, let's do the other way. Let's roll the D2 first. That's a Luther. Yeah. Roll me to hit against Luther.
No.
You try to maybe swipe to the side with the edge of your spear, but you, not quite realizing Luther is behind you, I think you critically hit your brother.
No.
21 doesn't clear by 5?
It clears by 4 as long as I'm facing her. Or
okay.
Someone.
Oh, because you've got the 17 AC from the shield.
Yeah.
Whoa. Just barely. Normal damage against Luther.
I still might die.
See, Ginger wants to be head of the family now.
or behead the family right now.
One HP.
Oh! Luther is badly wounded by his sister. He's down to 1 hit point.
I hate the dice today.
Has everyone taken Arthur? Everyone's gone, right?
Yeah.
Let's roll initiative again, and I gotta see if this remaining dog is up to the task of staying in combat. No, this one's not having it. This is not the ultimate guard dog.
What was that?
What do we have here? 6, 10, 12. And Luther, 7. Okay. The two of the bear-clawed men go at 5, so they go first. One of them is the one that has Spike. I think he probably just abandoned Spike right now. He drops the donkey, stops trying to pick it up, and goes to attack Arthur. He takes a swipe at Arthur with one of his claws for a 16 to hit.
I have 18 AC.
Ooh! Clatters against your armor, scraping and doing nothing. The other one continues to take a swipe at Ginger for a 17 to hit.
No, I mean, 18.
Your AC 18, very nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Does anyone beat a 7 for initiative?
Yeah, I got 6.
I tie that, and Jeff needs it.
All right, Jeff.
All right, against the doggy. I'm gonna try. Can I get flanked, or is it directly facing me?
No, it's facing you. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, okay. Very good.
No, never mind.
Oh. Okay. Yes, that is a double critical against the 2 HP badly wounded dog. Go ahead and...
Oh.
No, okay, that's plus 21. Okay.
I was going to say, how do you get 21?
It's more than 2. You drive a short sword through the dog, killing it. It drops to the ground.
I'm going to take on the... I'll try and get flank on the bearman who's going up against Arthur.
Sure. But that's going to be the end of it. The street is only so wide, so if you come around on the flank, it's going to be like a wall of these bearish men and you on the side, with no way to get past them again. But you can do it.
Okay.
16 is a hit. Yes. Five damage. Against the one on Arthur. All right. Wounded, but not dead.
Neil, just looking around, are there any more threats coming?
The bricks that were hovering, just kind of had stopped moving, are starting to rise in the air above your heads. But you don't see any other people in the street yet, but you did see a lot of things looking at you. There was something with an eye stalk that was following you, and you haven't seen it yet. And there are other weird creatures. There's definitely things about, they just haven't revealed themselves.
Man, that thing gets 8 attacks per round. That's it. That's game over. Damn.
I think we need to start running.
Yeah, we need to get out of here or take out that brick man.
Luther, you are tied with the other bear clawed man. So make your attack while he attacks Ginger. With a 19, no, I can do math. That is a 19 to hit.
That is a hit.
The claw comes in, ripping you for 3 points of damage.
Okay, Matt, 7 HP.
I think Luthu's gonna give up on his attack, and if I run to the donkey and grab the loot and start running back through the courtyard of the estate, how far can I get?
Like, you want to go back into the estate on the other side of the wall? You could get as far in as you need to be. You could get to the back side of the house if you really wanted.
Okay.
Absolutely. Except the problem is that the donkey is on the other side of these men with the claws. He was trying to take the donkey away and then abandon the donkey and move forward to get to you guys.
Mm-hmm.
So you couldn't get to...
They're both attacking Ginger now. And there's
but the street's only so wide, and there's 3 of them shoulder to shoulder with Stefan at the other end, so it's 4 people deep.
Break around them and then start running.
There's the wall to the estate on the other side of them.
Can I climb the wall?
So hop into the estate, hop over the wall, grab the stuff, hop back over the wall, and go back into the estate?
I think... Aren't the donkeys, like, kind of in the gateway?
Let's make a quick drawing here. So we have this wall, and there's a building across the street like this. So initially, Ginger came out of the gate, and they were dogs, right?
Yeah.
Back of them.
Mm-hmm.
Then Stefan came in with Arthur shooting from back, and Luther came over here with Donkey, which is going to be a lowercase d. Over here, right? And then Luther joined the fray fighting the dogs while the bear clawed men came in this way. And so now the bear clawed men are standing where Luther initially was, but he had moved to fight the dogs. Does that make sense?
Yeah, can I go that way over the wall and then go to the donkeys there, or are the...
You'd have to go back over the wall here.
Okay.
I'm going to try and redraw this so we don't get lost. But the donkeys are on the other side of the baddies.
Okay, can... Oh, those rocks are so worrying.
Make up your mind, or you lose your turn. Not to scale at all.
Okay, I guess I just pull out my arming sword and attack one of the bear men.
Hey. Go ahead and make it roll to hit.
There isn't is there a blocking action that will raise my AC or something, or guard?
Yes, there is. If you want to do a defensive action, I think it's called a total defense or something. It depends on what your class is.
Oh yeah, I think it's half your level and then plus one if you're a warrior.
I think for everyone else it's like 1/5 your level. Trying to find the player's handbook. There are block maneuvers that you can opt to take that creates like a post called shot against their attack every time it comes in to try and block it. There is a total defense in here somewhere.
I mean, does it look like we can disengage from them there, or do we have to kill them to actually get the donkey? Well, I mean, we do, don't we? So the situation.
I don't know how you could disengage and get to the donkeys.
Yeah, exactly right.
Yeah, I mean, we're all going to get killed by 8 attack per round rocks anyway.
So. Here we go.
Yeah, so we need to get these out to clear them through.
In order to make himself harder to hit, a character can parry, forfeit all actions in a round. He can't attack, move, or cast spells. This frees the character to concentrate solely on its defense. At this point, all characters but warriors gain an AC bonus to half their level. A 6th level wizard would gain a plus 3 bonus to his AC. A warrior gets a bonus equal to half his level plus 1. So you're a rogue, you're 3rd level, you would get a plus 1 to your AC.
That's not even worth it. Okay. Yeah.
If you kill one, then the action economy is reduced by a third.
I mean, unless you count the rocks, then it's reduced by like 11.
It's something we can't do anything about.
Make your roll to hit here, Luther. 18 is a hit. Three damage runs this guy through. He stumbles back, holding his gut, bleeding profusely from it, but not dead yet. Who's next?
I have a 10.
10 goes.
Okay. I'm going to attack the nearest guy with my saber.
Okay.
19. And I don't have any bonuses, so... Nope.
16 is a hit. No, that's not a 16. You rolled a 5. That's a miss. Yeah.
Okay, and here's the dagger. 15?
15's a hit.
Mm-hmm. 2 damage.
Wounding. Not killing. Ginger, you already went, right?
I'm at 12 this round.
Okay, so the last of these bear-clawed men goes. That one went, that one went. This one is going against Arthur. With a 13 to hit.
Nope.
Okay, Ginger, your turn.
Which one of the bearmen is most injured? Or most hit?
It's not the one directly in front of you. It's either the one Luther's been working on or the one Arthur and Stefan. They're both pretty bad. The one in front of you is totally fine.
Okay, well, it makes sense to me to attack the one that is threatening Luther most.
Okay.
Please don't stab me again.
I will just like...
You have a tiger-rich environment.
If that happens. Actually, I could take the penalties and go for the shield punch as well.
Your call.
But then I might not hit. All right, I'm going to just do a normal attack.
15 is a hit.
Okay.
Well, some damage here.
Just to the one.
Yeah, you rip him to shreds. He dies miserably.
Nice.
Did you have a second attack with the shield, or did you not do that?
No. This is just focusing with one weapon this round.
Does anyone have second attacks?
I do.
Stefan?
I was looking at that. Do we have that last round or this round?
It should be every other round. This is the 3rd round of combat, so you should have gotten it last round, but why don't we just give it to you this round?
Oh, look. No, I think I did have it last round then. I think we're okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so I think that was when you crit the dog.
Okay.
Yeah. I had it last round, and I killed brother.
Cool. All right, let's roll. Oh, wait, no.
I have a second saber attack.
Oh, right, your expertise. Nice. Alright,
let's see.
Attack.
Not that it matters.
Oh, and I also forgot about the bricks. Right. The bricks have risen off the ground. They are above head now. They're kind of spread out all over the place. And this time, instead of them falling one at a time, the whole lot of bricks just drops down, making two small attacks against everything, including the bear people.
Oh yeah, we're all close together.
That's a miss against Stefan, and a... what is this? A 16 against Stefan?
That's a hit.
Okay. D4 damage from a brick. Stefan takes 3 damage as a brick lands on his head.
I dropped to minus 1.
Okay. 2 attacks against one of the bear men. That is a 16 and an 8. The 16 hits. Bearman takes 4 points of damage and dies, or, you know, knocks unconscious, whichever you want to call it. The other bear guy gets hit once? No, twice. Sorry. Forgot his AC was so low. He takes 4 points of damage total. Let's see. Did we already roll attacks against Arthur?
No.
Nope. Thank you for being honest. 2 attacks against Arthur. That is an 18 and a 6.
1 hit.
You take 1 point of damage. Ginger, 2 bricks falling towards you. That's a 12 and a 19.
19's a hit.
2 points of damage. And Luther,
5.
It's a 2 and a 15.
Ooh, I'm safe.
Okay. So the bricks tumble to the ground around you guys. And we roll initiative for the next round.
Right, what should I roll if I am to drop my stuff and attempt to save Stefan?
If you want to bind his wounds, you don't have to roll at plus 3.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah. But you are currently engaged with one of these bear clawed men.
I am.
So if you move to help Stefan before the guy is dead, he'll get an attack of opportunity against you.
You know what? Risk it. Do it.
Okay. 12, 14, 12, 7.
Can she choose to go at the end of the round?
Yes, she can delay her action to the end if she would like. The enemy goes at 13, so Patrick, Luther, you're up first.
Okay, I disengage and back up into the courtyard and then throw a dagger.
Can't disengage, back up, and throw a weapon. Disengage is a half action, then the move, and then the... Oh, I guess you have...
Is it disengaging a move?
Disengaging is a full move action, allowing you to go up to 1/3 your movement rate away from the enemy.
Okay.
So you wouldn't be able to get your attacks at the end of it. You could disengage and clear yourself, but not get attacks.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. You've disengaged and pulled back. Stefan, at 12, takes a point of bleeding damage. Autumn, you can go now, or you can wait until after Arthur's made his attack.
Yeah, wait. I'll delay.
Cool. The bear goes now, making an attack against Ginger with his claws, which is a 5. Miss. Arthur?
Since the one I was just fighting got killed by the bricks, can I flank this guy?
Yeah.
Alright. Let's see. Go saber time. Probably not.
Nope. One more is all you needed. You have a knife in your offhand?
Dagger.
Saving throw versus death?
That was just a 4, sorry. And a fail.
A fail on the save?
Yep.
By how much? By more than 8, huh?
I'm not sure what my saving throw is.
Alright, make your attack against Ginger.
Isn't Ginger on the other side if he went for a flank?
If you look at the map right here, Arthur's on the side of the bear, so Ginger is still adjacent to him.
He has his dagger in his left hand and he's going, ugh.
So he's like making a stab towards the bear man, but like stumbles and kind of stumbles in towards Ginger.
All right, well, I'm not flanking Ginger, so.
No. And she's got super high AC, yeah. So your dagger just kind of clatters into the side of her armor with no meaningful effect whatsoever. Ginger, you can go and stabilize the guy. The bear guy gets an attack against you. Natural 19, which makes it a total of 21. Is that clear by 8? Oh, clear by 5?
18, no. 21, no.
No, okay. All right. It's just a normal hit with his claws against you for 3 points of damage.
All right. I'm down to 2 HP.
Oh, dear God. You have a healing proficiency, so you can instantly, not instantly, but in that round, you can stabilize Arthur. Stefan.
I'm gonna do that and just like look up, try and make eye contact with Luther and just say, should I carry him? Leave the donkey? You pick.
Wait, you haven't someone picked has.
Let's roll initiative.
Okay. Bearman's still up, so we better make attack initiative.
7, 12, 11. Guy goes at 8, and...
Hold on, I got to Stefan in the same round he took the damage, didn't he? So I could make the check to heal him for damage, right? But he's unconscious.
Is that still alive? You spent your round bandaging his wounds, so...
heals.
Yeah, that.
I guess you can't heal people in negative, yeah. Can you? No. Okay. Just checking.
Okay, so.
Well, yeah, I can still get the hit points. I might still be unconscious. So.
Patrick, you go first.
It's probably gonna keep on running.
Is that an attack against the throwing? So that guy's still engaged with Arthur. So that comes at a penalty to hit, or is a firing into melee.
Arthur's behind it, though.
Yeah, but that's still, you know, you miss him, you could hit Arthur pretty easily.
Yeah, I mean, you should try and use ranged combat in the fight like this is...
Yeah, it's messy. Real messy. So either way, it's a miss. And the bear guy goes next, squaring off with Arthur, slashing for a 10 to hit. No dice. 12 to hit. I forgot to add his bonus of 2 to hit. No dice. Leaving us with Autumn at 11.
Okay. I'm going to stand up and attack this bear.
No good. Okay. You guys see the bricks begin to rise again and start to slowly move their way up in the air.
I get my last 2 attacks.
Yes, and also Arthur gets his attack.
Yeah. And I'm still flanking him.
Oh, I think I hit with one.
The 12 is a hit, and the 17's a hit.
Another max damage.
3 points of damage, leaving him at 1 HP, which is then completely wiped away.
Yep.
All right. You guys are surrounded by the corpses of these bear-clawed people and these two-headed dogs. Stefan is unconscious. Your donkeys are startled and kind of pushing themselves against this wall right here, freaking out and trying to... Yeah, that didn't show up for you guys. Trying to escape into an area where they can't escape. They clearly don't want to go this way, and they don't want to go this way. They're freaking out.
Okay, I'm going to glance at the bricks quickly and then sheathe my saber and go over to the donkeys and try to calm them down.
Oh, you have some nice animal skills for that, don't you? Yep. With domesticated animals, I don't think you need to make a check or anything. I think you can just calm them. How long does it take? Is it a one-round action? I think it's a one-round action. I just want to double-check. And befriend it automatically. Doesn't say. But it makes sense that it would take a full round to calm down a panicky animal. Sure. So you can calm down the donkey without much of an issue. Ginger and Luther, what are you doing?
See the bricks are rising. I want to start picking up Stefan, but also can I make some sort of judgment on the height of which the bricks were at last time and the rate of which they're going?
It looks like it'll take the full round for them to reach the height they were at last time.
All right, so like pick up Stefan and move towards the donkeys.
I don't know if you can physically pick Stefan up, but you can drag him. Stefan's a little heavy for you to lift. 179 pounds plus gear.
I hook him under the armpits and move him that way.
Sure. You slide him over to the donkeys, which are calming now. Luther?
Is there any, like, a porch or something I can get under?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so I'll get under there.
I should also note that the bricks are pretty much just in, like, this area. So it's easy for you, to where you are, to step out beyond them. You can go under the roof, which is even further back.
Yeah, I'll get under the roof, because I don't know that they're just going to go straight down, I don't think.
It's true. They could go down in any direction.
Yeah.
Okay. So, next round, let's roll some initiatives. Primarily, Arthur and Ginger, I need you guys to roll initiative. Luther, not so much for you.
All right. So am I putting Stefan on the donkeys or under the donkeys? I don't know.
Well, doesn't matter. The bricks fall before either of you guys get to take your actions. Stefan, they roll an 8 and a 10 against you. So they don't land on your face. They just kind of land on your armored body, and you're fine.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. It's the dice. It's not me. Ginger, they roll, a 16 and 17 against you. You have 18 AC, though, don't you?
18?
Nice. Yeah. Tyler, 10 and a 12.
Both misses.
I forgot to attack your donkeys last time, but we won't bother rolling it for it last time. We'll just roll for it this time. The spike gets a 15 and 17 against him. Those are hits. And is Doris the other one, or is Doris your first donkey?
Doris the second.
This is Doris the second. Okay. Doris gets a 9 and a 13. I think donkey AC is 13. Right.
Yeah, 13.
So spike takes 8 points of damage. Ooh, max damage. Right. And Doris the second takes a single point.
He's at 8 HP.
Okay. Party's turn to do everything.
I'm yelling to get away from the rocks, I guess. And I'm considering, how long would it take to take off my chainmail?
A round.
Okay, so I'm going to put Stefan onto Doris the second. And start... I guess we'll lead them inside this place, right? Yeah, lead them in.
Lead them into the...
house? I think I'll start waving you off. Because we have to go back out the gate.
Okay. I'll go... Can I lead the donkeys, like, enough that way to feel like I'm out of range of tricks?
What are you doing with Stefan, though? Right now, he is...
I'll pick Stefan up and put him on the donkeys.
Okay, so Ginger and Arthur together put Stefan on Doris the second? Or Spike?
Well, Luther cowers.
Yeah.
Luther just got stabbed for 7 damage by his sister.
I think everyone is in the exact same position, and I'm probably worse off than you.
All right, so between Ginger and Arthur, you managed to hoist Stefan on Doris the second and start to lead her out, start to lead both of the donkeys outside of the brick range, the area where they're rising.
Yep.
Luther, are you taking off your armor?
Yeah, Luther's taking off his chainmail.
You're just gonna deposit it on the ground?
No, he's going to run over to the donkeys and put it. See, okay, so if the donkeys go that way, it's this way to get out of town, right?
The bridge is this way, and the river exit is down.
Okay, and the bridge is quicker?
Bridge is closer.
Okay, so if they go that way, once they get my chainmail off, I'm going to go over the wall, like there, and put it on the donkeys.
Sure. Not too difficult of a thing. You guys start moving down the streets.
I don't know if I'll move with them, though.
With the donkeys. How much can a donkey carry? We should actually probably take a break here, since this is the closest thing we've had to a nice stopping point in a while. When we come back from break, we'll figure out how fast the donkeys can move with a full-grown person on them, and we'll hope that our heroes make it out alive. See you guys on the other side.